Hello, everybody. I'm Father Tom Weisbacher, pastor at St. James Parish here in Omaha. I welcome you to our bi-weekly parish update. It looks like we're getting closer and closer to winter. You may have noticed the snow on Monday, and fortunately it didn't last long in the ground, and we're hoping things will warm up a little bit in the days ahead before any serious snow comes. Also, just a little reminder, daylight savings time starts this weekend, this early Sunday morning, so you might want to set your clocks back Saturday night so you can show up to Mass on time. We do encourage everyone to consider coming back to Mass at these times. There's plenty of room in the church for social distancing. We are nowhere near 50% capacity, and we're doing our best to keep everybody safe. The spiritual benefits of celebrating Mass are in person are certainly worth the effort to come, such as receiving Holy Communion. Please come and join us. It's hard to imagine, but this Sunday is the beginning of November. 2020 is almost over. Where has it gone so quickly? We're approaching Thanksgiving and the end of the church year. It's not only harvest time, it's also we meditate on the last things of our human existence. Can you imagine? Advent's only 4.5 weeks away. This Sunday is actually All Saints Day, November 1st. It's a holy day, but it's a Sunday, so it's not a problem when we honor all the saints in heaven, particularly those who are unnamed. You know, there's probably billions of saints in heaven, and you know, they're just including our ancestors, our grandparents, great-grandparents, great-great-great-great-grandparents, and you know, this is a chance for us to honor them for all the good things they did. And you know, how do we ever get in of the church and get our faith? And we want to just say thank you to all these holy men and women who have gone before us. The next day, next Monday, is All Souls Day. This is the day we remember all those who have passed away but are still on their way to heaven. Purgatory is a reality, and there, where those who have died but have not reached the perfection of God the Father or, spend some time making up for their sinful mistakes and perfecting their moral character. By our prayers and good deeds, we can help them shorten their time there and get to heaven sooner. You know, we'll talk about indulgences and the good things we do that can help them in a concrete way. We've had a lot of deaths this year. I mean, it's twice of what we had last year. And we'll have all the names on two banners this year to get them all on a banner in the church so we can remember and pray for our beloved dead throughout the month of November. So we will actually have a special Mass of remembrance for those who have passed away this past year on next Monday evening at 7:00. We invite people to come join us. The next day, next Tuesday, is Election Day in our country. I pray that everyone will do his or her civic and moral duty to vote. Obviously, this is a very important election to prepare our decide for the future of our country. Personalities matter somewhat, but what is most important is what the policies that individuals will push forward. We as Catholics have the moral obligation to stand up for the right to life at all its stages, from conception to natural death. The one we must defend the most diligently in this crazy world we live in, that's under attack in our country and throughout the world. Other considerations are our religious liberty, the sanctity of marriage, as God designed it between one man and one woman, and the holiness of what a family really is. As citizens of the United States, we have a moral obligation to take part in our elective government, and now is the time to do so. Please pray over your vote and ask the good Lord to help you and our fellow citizens to make the right choices in this election. Last weekend, we had our in-church sign-up for the Archdiocesan Annual Appeal. Thank you to all those who have filled out their annual appeal forms. Obviously, there's still time to do so. We encourage everyone to send in their card. Even if you can't make a financial commitment, please check the box to promise to pray for Archbishop and the Archdiocese and send in your card. We would love to have every family of our parish send in the card. And thank you very much for considering doing so. There's still time to sign up also for our St. James Parish Annual Stewardship Renewal. Thank you to all those who already have. And if you need a form, just call the office. We'll be happy to send one to you. St. James Seton School and our religious ed programs are moving forward fairly well. We started our school masses last week on Wednesday and Thursday, and I think that went fairly well. And they will be continuing every week. Let's keep our students, teachers, staff, volunteers, and administrators in our prayers so that they can continue to smoothly in the future. Our programs can continue smoothly in the future. Our yearly SOAR dinner is coming up on Saturday, November 21st. Again, that's coming fairly quickly. Because of the pandemic, it will be virtual this year, although everyone is invited to order a takeout dinner from Taxi's Grill and Bar. The details will be on our bulletin that folks can pick up in the gym from 5:30 to 7:30 that evening. There will also be a silent auction. Feel free to contact the school if you have something you'd like to donate to the silent auction or to make a cash donation. The full schedule and details can be found, as I said, in the bulletin. Please join us and support our St. James Seton Grade School. We are moving forward on a couple of our church improvement projects, which should be happening in the next few weeks and will be completed hopefully by the end of November. We are putting in a high-definition video system so we can live stream and record our Masses in the future. We've been recording our Saturday evening Masses and putting them up on Sunday mornings, which has been going well, but this will be less people-intensive and higher quality. We will also be able to unobtrusively record weddings and funerals and other church events in the future. A second improvement will be a wireless sound system for the hard of hearing. It's been a while since our hearing enhancement system has worked, and now it's being upgraded. The sound of the church will be broadcast on an FM frequency that can be picked up on your own cell phone or radio. Again, more details will be coming in the future. Just a couple reminders, we are still hearing confessions every Saturday evening from 3 to 4:30, and we are selling hope certificates after every weekend Mass nowadays. I'd like to again thank all of you who have been so generous with your Sunday contributions. May you be blessed for helping us in these difficult times. To conclude, let's keep in our prayers that this pandemic will wind down soon. Those who are sick will get better. We'll be protected from anything like that, or everything in the school, parish will be able to continue to run smoothly in the future. Let's keep praying and spending some precious time in front of the Blessed Sacrament. That's how we can win this battle. And thanks again for tuning in today, and have a great week, everybody. May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.